This is Tony Antonucci from Chi-Town Constrictors, and welcome back. I recently posted something on Facebook that I got a very overwhelming response, where I was flirting with the idea of maybe making a series of short videos for you guys to follow along a couple of my pairings in my breeding season. That way I can show you guys exactly what I do, maybe some of the problems that I come across, some of the tricks that I use to be a little bit more successful. Everybody was pretty much unanimous that they wanted to see it and that they would enjoy it, so we're gonna go ahead and do it, alright? I've got here my ultrasound. I'm going to show you guys how I use that. I'm going to show you one or two of my pairings, and I'm going to keep you guys posted throughout my entire season. I don't know if it'll be week by week or every other week, but I'm going to let you guys follow the progression from beginning all the way, hopefully, to babies and see exactly what I do. So I've had a lot of people reach out to me saying that they're new to boas. Some people, this is even going to be their first time ever trying breeding, and they're looking for some tips and some pointers. I have a lot of friends that would probably be very upset with me if I didn't share what is probably my biggest secret. The most important thing that you can do to breeding boas is you have to go out and you have to get yourself some sleeveless shirts. I get a lot of grief because it seems like every video that I do, I'm always wearing a sleeveless shirt. That hasn't gone unnoticed, guys, and there's a reason for that. Tip of the pros is get yourself some sleeveless shirts. You'll thank me later, okay? It's the most important thing you can do. Without it, your season is going to be completely shot before it ever began. So now that we got the most important part of breeding boas out of the way, now we're going to go to the next thing. This is my ultrasound. This is a Sonoscope A6 model. It's the only one I've ever used, so I can't say that it's necessarily better or worse than any other models out there. I know a lot of people that have ultrasounds like theirs or don't like theirs for their different reasons. It works. It does exactly what I need it to do. It allows me to see the follicles, follow follicle growth, and even see once a female is gravid whether or not she's going to have good babies or she's going to have slugs. So I've got a female here that I haven't checked yet. I really don't know where she's going to be. Maybe she's ready for a male, maybe she's not. But we're going to take a look and we'll see where it goes from there. So this is one of the females that I've picked out to show you guys the progression and see how her breeding season goes. This is a 2014 VPI T-positive Sunglow Harlequin female that I produced. She's been a holdback of mine. She was born in May of 2014, so she's almost 3.5 years old. She's roughly 14, 15 pounds or so. I did try to breed her last year, but she reabsorbed her follicles, so I never got anything from her, but we're going to try her again this year. But big, beautiful female, a little bit of a nasty attitude sometimes. And what I'm hoping to do is plug some more color into her and just make some really, really colorful hets. I'll show you guys the male that I have picked out for her in a little bit. But why don't we get the ultrasound on her and see what we're looking at. So guys, I apologize. I don't have enough hands here to be doing this all by myself. But you can see on the screen here a lot of darkness. You can see a lot of big circles here. That is actually one of last year's follicles. And this is why it's my opinion that reabsorption doesn't happen as quickly as we think it does. Because that's a follicle from last year. But if you look real closely, you can see, let me find it again. You can see right in here this little tiny black spot. That's a new follicle that's starting to develop. So as of right now, it's very, very little. Let me freeze it here. We can rewind, get it as clear as we can. I'll measure the distance, and that follicle's only 7.5 millimeters. So she's nowhere near ready to see a male yet. Ideally, you wanna see follicles between 16 to 25. That's what I consider prime for breeding, but obviously, as you can see, only 7.5, she's nowhere near ready, so I'm not even going to bother putting a male in yet. So like we just saw, she's only 7.5 millimeters, she's nowhere near ready to breed. Like I said, the window that I usually look for is between 16 to 25, that's where I like to introduce a male. They usually ovulate between 40 to 45 millimeters, so between 15 to 25, that's a good time to introduce the male, get them breeding, get a lot of sperm in her, make sure you get all of those follicles fertilized. And then you can watch the growth and progression of how those follicles will get bigger and bigger before ovulation. There are a lot of little tricks that you can use to help stimulate your female to develop follicles a lot quicker. One of the biggest things that you can do that probably works the fastest is just to get a male in there. Once a male starts courting her, it'll kind of stimulate her and turn her on, and you'll see those follicles really grow quickly. If you're not looking to waste your male's energy for nothing, which I personally don't like to do, there's other things you can do, such as some people like to do what's called temperature cycling. Drop the temperatures, drop the humidity. That kind of triggers what they experience out in the wild, and it'll get the females to cycle as well. I personally have not cycled temperatures in years, and I have just as much success now as I did back when I used to cycle the temperatures. So the method that I choose to prepare my females and help stimulate their follicles is for about a month, month and a half, I'll feed them pretty heavy. Maybe give them double meals, or if you don't want to give them a double meal because it's too much at once, maybe do their meals a little bit more frequently, maybe once a week or even twice a week, and that sometimes helps the follicles grow as well. So that's it for this episode, guys. I'm going to go ahead and give her a couple of meals. We'll check her again in a couple of weeks, and I'll let you guys know where it goes from there. Please subscribe. If you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments. Get a hold of me on Facebook. Follow my Instagram. Whatever you have to do. If I haven't answered it in this video, I'll try to in the next one, and I'm going to really try to steer you guys in the right direction and show you what I do, and hopefully we'll get some babies by the time it's done. Take care, guys.